dope. Yo, wow, that's crazy. You knew a lot. You knew a lot of stuff.
Hey guys, thanks for tuning in. I'm Damon Campbell here at the intersection in Grand Rapids, Michigan, with a very special guest. Would you like to introduce yourself?
What's up, man? My name is KOTA, Brooklyn, New York.
Great to meet you, man.
Nice to meet you, too.
Definitely, man. Appreciate your time.
Word, of course.
Now, it seems like fans have been waiting on pins and needles for your headline tour, but going back a moment, what was it like opening for Slum Village at the Knitting Factory?
Wow. TBT. It was so long ago, it's crazy, but it was my first real, like, introduction to what a concert is.
Sure.
You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
I never witnessed anything like that, especially like to be on the same stage as like Slum Village.
Right.
Like, you know? So it really bugged me out, and it really gave me a, just opened my eyes to what it could be. You
For
know?
Sure.
So, yeah.
Back then you were going by, was it Avlife?
Avlife.
Avlife?
Yeah. Yeah, because my real name is Avery.
Okay.
So I would call myself Ave. Everybody called me Ave.
Sure.
So I just added the life to it, and that was my name.
It was also with Nappy Hair?
Yeah, that was my group. My group is Nappy Hair, and like it was just me and a couple of my college friends.
Okay.
And we just having fun, smoking a lot of weed, making a lot of music. That's it.
Yeah. Do you know what those guys are up to these days? Or?
I mean, life, I guess.
Sure,
just
yeah.
Like, you know, I'm sure life, women,
yeah.
Weed, happiness.
Of course.
Sadness, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I don't really know. Sometimes we talk, sometimes we don't. It's
yeah.
sad, but, you know.
Well, yeah. And on that note, while you're out here traveling the globe, I understand you'd like your music to kind of help serve as like a map out of depression.
Definitely, yeah, for sure. Like, it's... I don't ever want to make music in vain. You know what I mean? I don't want anything I do to be in vain or to be just like, just because I want to drop something. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
I feel like there's always something to be said. And so I make sure that if I'm going to drop something, it's something of value. You
for
know?
Sure.
Yeah.
And for you, the light at the end of the tunnel had a lot to do with acceptance.
Yeah, it's definitely acceptance of yourself, acceptance of the things you've done in the past. You know what I mean? And the things that have happened to you in the past and things that people have done to you, so you don't feel like vengeful, and just like really just accepting you as a person, and then you can learn to accept other people
for
you
sure
know, for who they are.
Yeah,
you know,
I suppose it could be said that music was your calling, so it's fitting that you actually started recording songs on an old answering machine.
Yeah that's so crazy. Yeah, me and my cousins used to gather around an old voice recorder and with the tape and everything. So I remember rewinding the tape and all that, you know what I mean? And we would just lay down tracks, like tracks, quote unquote. And we used to just rap over like any instrumentals we could find off of LimeWire back in the day. And we would just throw on, like we play the instrumental from like a speaker, a computer speaker, a laptop speaker or something.
Okay.
And we record it onto the tape machine, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And we sit down writing vigorously to like Jay-Z instrumentals, Biggie Smalls instrumentals, whatever we could put our hand, Kanye.
Yeah.
It was like, that was a big one. Like always finding new Kanye instrumentals, and we would just like rap around. We'd all sit around the tape recorder and just rap into the tape recorder like
right.
yo blah, blah.
Yeah,
so it was good times.
And sometimes you would pretend to be Memphis Bleek.
No. I wasn't Memphis Bleek. I was always Jay, you
okay.
know what I mean? And somebody in the squad was Memphis Bleek.
Okay.
And somebody like my female sister would be, my female cousin would be like Foxy Brown.
Wow.
Or something, or like, you know. And somebody, or my cousin was Diddy. He
okay.
was always, he said he was Diddy or Dame Dash or something like that. You
yeah.
know what I mean? And so, yeah.
And Jay-Z's In My Lifetime was instrumental for you in particular?
Yeah. That was the first beat that I ever really rapped on. You know
Crazy.
What I mean? So that was like, I vividly remember just like trying to mimic his flow.
Okay.
And learn from his wittiness, you know
yeah.
what I mean? And I was like, really, at that time, I didn't even realize I was doing it, but
right.
I was learning nuance, you know, from Jay-Z and Biggie Smalls, and that's how you know that their writing is really advanced, you
yeah.
know what I mean? Because it's like, they can say things without saying them, and I learned how to say things without saying them.
Wow.
I learned how to describe a picture rather than say that the picture's there, you know
right.
what I mean? And so they told me a lot, and it's just like, yeah, that's crazy. Yeah.
Was that also when you realized you have synesthesia?
Oh, that was later on.
Oh, was
that
it?
That was later on when I started doing drugs.
Oh, really?
Nah, because it's like, I remember sitting at the just I had this when I was in college. I had this old amplifier, and it was like right up on my desk, and I used it as speakers. You know what I mean? Because I was a guitar player before I got into like hip hop.
Oh, wow!
And so I would just have it on my desk, and I would just like literally make these beats with these chords and instruments and things like that, and like with the keyboard, and I would just play it back, and I would just be in this whole trance. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And that's when I started seeing sound in like as like raindrops and dots and things like that, and like, you know, in different ways, and it really taught me how to see music. You
totally.
Know what I mean? Yeah.
Speaking of which, NERDs seeing sounds had quite an impact on you as well.
Yeah. Seeing sounds was like, that was like the soundtrack to my high school life. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Not just seeing sounds, like his other albums, like Fly or Die, the other albums, and like Fly or Die. And, you know, I was getting lost in the music because, the songs were just so impactful
right.
to me. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, it was just so beautiful. Like, the stuff that they were saying through the music and the vibe and the rock mixed with jazz and, you know, soul. It's like, I was digging it, man.
Yeah.
I was digging it.
I'm not sure if you were considered a nerd in school, but you mm-hmm. did receive a scholarship to play trumpet.
Yeah. I wasn't considered a nerd. I mean, I don't know. Maybe some people, I'm sure, thought I was a nerd, but I didn't think I was a nerd.
Not necessarily even a bad thing.
Nah, it's not a bad thing. I just don't, like, I knew of nerds, you know what I'm saying? And I was cool with everybody.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I knew the people that people would call nerds. And first of all, it's a whack, you know, term to use, period.
Agreed,
you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's just stupid. But... Because I think you can be cool with everybody. And the cool squad was always, like, the corniest squad, bro.
Yeah.
Like, and I learned that, like, early. I was just like, damn. As soon as I was invited to be around the cool kids,
yeah.
I was like, damn, y'all whack as fuck, bro. And so, but, nah, like, trumpet got me everywhere. You know what I mean? Like, ever since I was in elementary school, that's when the teacher realized I had a gift. And he was just like, oh, let's put him up to the... next. So I was always in the advanced class.
Wow.
You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
And after elementary school, I went to specialized junior high school for music, and then
crazy.
A specialized high school, and then I was in I was doing it basically.
Right,
I was
yeah.
really like, I was in like Manhattan School of Music for trumpet, like in different programs in different places and different bands and everything.
Yeah.
And so that's where I got my start as far as like classic, like being classically trained.
Totally.
In an instrument. Yeah.
Initially, however, you wanted to play saxophone, but there weren't enough available.
Yeah. That's so crazy. Shout out to public school. You know what I mean? But yeah, I wanted to play like I really wanted to play the sax, but there was like, it was like impossible because they were like, oh, there's not enough saxes.
Yeah.
Like they made you put down two instruments. You know what I mean?
Sure.
In case.
Like a backup.
In case you didn't, you know,
yeah.
in case you didn't want your first one. And saxophone was my first one. Trumpet was my second one. So I was tight. You know what I mean? I was like, and on top of that, it's like, it's so crazy because like the other kids weren't even that good. You know what I mean? As the kids that had the saxophones,
right.
You know what I mean? So, like, it was just crazy the fact that they got to play it.
Sure.
You know what I mean? So, it's kind of wild how that, it's like, this is how you shape a child's whole future.
Right.
It's like, there's not enough.
Yeah.
Sick.
Is your mom a teacher?
Yeah.
What does she teach?
She's a dance teacher.
Oh,
yeah,
really?
She's a dance teacher.
How long has she been doing that for?
She's been doing it since I can remember, probably more than 25 years.
Okay.
Maybe like 25 years. Crazy.
Have you picked up any moves?
Hell no. Hell no. I'm a terrible dancer.
Okay.
But when I was younger, I had some potential for
Did
sure.
Okay.
Yeah. But I got older. I got self, you know, self. I got insecure. You know
Happens
what I mean?
To the best of us, you I know? Guess.
So yeah,
yeah.
But I was she was. I would actually. She bought me a pair of tap shoes. So I was gonna start tap dancing.
Yeah.
But then I just music was just what it was.
Took
you
over,
know.
Yeah.
So yeah.
Now that you've got your foot in the door, how does it feel to finally be getting your credit after being a student of the game for so long?
Honestly, it's cool, you know what I mean? But at the same time, I know that it doesn't define me, you
sure.
know? And so it feels good to feel that, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So to have done it for so long under the radar, but at the same time getting love from fans and things like that.
Totally.
I know that that's what matters, you know what I mean? And everything is cool. The billboards are cool, the, you know, double XLs, the... this and the that and the articles and the love is that's good. You know what I mean?
Right.
But at the end of the day, if that all goes away tomorrow, I'll still be happy because I'll still be making music. People will still be listening. You know what I mean? Yeah. So I don't stress that, and it's great. But it's like everything else. Nothing is guaranteed. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
It's that acceptance.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Exactly. You accept where you at. Like, I appreciate where I'm at, man. Like, every step of the way. Like, totally. A year ago, I said the same thing. You know, a year ago, I was like, yo, I appreciate where I'm at. And we're gonna get more. We're going to go farther. But right now, I'm good.
Totally.
You know, what more can I ask for? I'm making music. And I get to feed my family, man.
Just that gratitude.
You know, yeah, I'm grateful, 100%.
And one of the first times hip-hop kind of swept you off your feet was ironically at a sneaker store, VIM.
Yeah. I was at VIM, and where we used to go sneaker shopping. And, well, not just clothes shopping, like every summer.
Too, right?
Like, they do jeans, everything. They had every type of clothes you could think about. But, well, it was really like urban wear, you know, streetwear. So, I was at VIM with my family, and it was so crazy about it. We used to go to the same store like 4 times during the week. Like, it was weird. I never understood it. I never understood why we were in the same stores 4 times. Like, it was crazy. But that was the first time that I don't even remember how old I was, but that was the first time that I heard All Falls Down by Kanye. Uh-huh. And I was just like, it blew me away because it's like, I'd never heard this guy do any. I was like, what? All I remember was thinking, whose voice is this? Right. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, who's saying all of this powerful stuff, making me think about things in a way I never thought about them? Yeah. Like, yo, and once my older brother, he told me, yo, that's Kanye, bro. That's Kanye West. And after that, I was, yo, it's so crazy to think now I was the biggest Kanye fan. Wow. You know what I mean? Like, I was literally like, I was Kanye's biggest fan, man. Like, College Dropout was my favorite album.
Yep.
Is even to this day.
Yeah.
Yo, it had 21 tracks on it, and I loved it. You know what I mean? Like, it was beautiful. Like, I can't even go. I can go on and on and on. I know every lyric to that album. And that just kind of brought me into a new world. You know, I used to be on Rockefeller website looking for, like, listening to the snippets of his of Late Registration. And it goes back so deep that, like, I would be on a website listening to, like, I would hear some songs that you would hear now and be like, oh, this is how the song goes, but there was a snippet with a completely different beat, with a completely different you know, hook, everything, you know, because it was like a raw version of what they were about to drop.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
For
and
sure.
So, like, once I found Kanye, I was like, that was the first piece of music that I discovered on my own, and I just decided that I like this no matter what. You know what I mean? Like, this is hot.
Totally.
You know?
So. And I understand you're all about lifting people up because without actually walking a mile in someone's shoes, who are we to not love and accept them for who they are?
True. Yeah, 100%. Like, I feel like everybody deserves to be understood. You know what I mean? There's so many people out here just misunderstood, and just like people coming at them from every way, you know, and it's like it's overwhelming, you know. And so I believe in giving people chances, and I believe in loving people. I believe in loving the people that have hurt you, you know, and understanding that everybody has trauma, you know what I mean? Everybody has something that they're trying to get through, the bully and the bullied, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So like, just as much as I sympathize with the people that were bullied, because I've been bullied in my life, you got to sympathize with the people that are doing the bullying, because, you know what I mean? Hurt people, you know? Especially children and stuff like that. And, like, we're all really just grown children.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's it.
Yeah.
You know, we learned, most of what we, you know, picked up was in childhood.
For sure.
You know, so we carry all that shit with us, you know? And so right now, we're just literally reflections of the things that have happened to us.
True.
So
yeah. And on that note, you've been quoted as saying that you hope to free people from the shackles of society, remove stigmas, and create a healthy environment for people to thrive mentally, emotionally, and spiritually. Can you elaborate?
Definitely. I through my music, I try to keep it open as possible. I try to keep it inclusive of everybody, as well as, like, touch on, even when I touch on situations that impact a certain group of people, it's like I'm still trying to make it inclusive. I want people to understand each other. You know what I mean? I feel like it's important, because it's just like it's hard. It's hard out there, you know. And everybody's just like, everybody's at each other's necks.
For sure.
So I'm trying to create this space where it's, dude, just be yourself. Like, nobody's coming at you. I'm not coming at you. They're not. And that's men, women, black, white, whatever, because there's always these disconnections, you know? And I treat everybody with respect and love. And it's, I can be mad at you 1 minute and not care about it the next minute. And, like, that's my whole thing is just, yo, let's get over it, you know?
For sure. Is there anything else you'd like people to know about KOTA the Friend?
Not really, man. Got it all out.
Well, thank you so much for your time, man. It was great chatting with you.
Thank you, fam.
Best wishes with everything coming your way. Any final thoughts at all before we say goodbye?
Final thoughts? Ready for this tour. I'm ready to show the people what's up. And after that, I don't really know. No plans.
There you have it. Once again, I'm Damon Campbell, and this is KOTA the Friend. Thanks for watching.